And here is this week's diagnosis of the week. Hit me with your diagnosis, Dr. Cliff.
I'm going to try this a different way this time. I'm going to throw out some symptoms, and I'm going to see if you guys can guess what it is. Now, you don't have to figure out the
malaria.
Scientific term. Wrong. You lose. 20 push-ups. We've got, let's say this is a 12-year-old golden retriever, and all of a sudden has had an immediate onset of balance problems. Sort of its eyes are twitching, almost like a mini seizure. Can't even stand, maybe even vomiting. Definitely something neurological going on. What do you guys think it could be?
Late onset epilepsy?
That's a good question or a good comment. Epilepsy doesn't generally occur when they're older. Unfortunately, when they have a true seizure, you're more worried about something like a stroke or a tumor. It is possible.
How about dementia?
Dementia? No, not really. Dogs do get cognitive dysfunction.
Why
syndrome,
are you so nice
slow.
To the way he responds to a question? But for me, it's no, not really.
Because you know better. Come on. All right, try again.
Is it a tumor?
It is a tumor. No, it is not the tumor, though that is a possible differential. The big thing with this disease is it's the balance, the coordination. If it's affecting one side of the body, let's say the right side, they're going to be falling over to the right and circling to the right constantly. Does that help at all?
I would think they've had a stroke.
You would think they've had a stroke.
Can they get vertigo?
They can get vertigo. That's true. Well, now vertigo is kind of a bogus term because vertigo just means bad balance. I mean, it's not actually a diagnosis.
The whiskers got chopped?
No. You know what? So the condition is called canine. Those are all great possibilities. Canine idiopathic vestibular syndrome.
I was just going to say that.
Idiopathic means we don't really know what causes it. Vestibular is the balance center, so vestibular syndrome. And it hits dogs generally when they're older, very rare in cats. And most of these dogs come into my clinic, and the family is ready to say goodbye. They think their dog has had a stroke because it looks exactly like a stroke. It hits golden retrievers more often and more severely than other dogs, but it can hit any dog. And it's basically an inner ear inflammation. And your inner ear, the little shell, fluid-filled shaped thing, it's called the cochlea. The inner ear, that's what manages your balance. And it's, you know, if someone smacks you in the ear or you get that boxer who gets punched in the ear and he wobbles for a second, that's because his inner balance is gone. And the nice thing about this is, you know, there's a few symptoms or a few signs that are very, very typical for the disease that help us determine if it's a stroke versus vestibular. And so these families come in ready to say goodbye. It's very, very tragic. And we say, your dog's going to be fine in about 2 weeks. You know, he's going to be wobbling. You're going to have to watch him around stairs. And, you know, we may have to give him some supportive medication to help with the vertigo and to help with the nauseousness. But I have never lost a patient due to this, and it's almost every single time. Doc, I think Rover has had a stroke. The family has said goodbye. The kids are in the car crying. You know, where do I sign? And I usually say, hold on a minute. I'm going to save your dog's life.
Good for you.
Thanks, man.
Good for you.
Canine vestibular syndrome.
Basically, it's a bad ear infection.
Well, except it's not infectious. We don't really know.
You don't really know. It's just something to do with the ear.
It's just inflammation.
With your balance.
Yeah, but it's not infectious.